Browsing with a desktop screen reader. Screen readers announce everything on a web page and within an application. All static text is spoken, including paragraphs of text, headings, and lists. Screen readers also announce additional information, such as text descriptions for images, visually hidden text, and the names of landmark regions, for example banner, main, and footer, when browsing web content. As an example, here's an extract from the tetralogical.com site, as experienced with a screen reader.
Link skip to main content, visited link graphic tetralogical, main navigation landmark list with 4 items, visited link about, visited link services, visited link news, visited link log out of list, main landmark heading level 1 below, we're tetralogical, we're a company with inclusion at its heart, we specialize in all aspects of accessibility, from working with your websites and apps to giving your teams the skills they need to make accessibility part of everything they do.
For interactive elements, screen readers will not only announce the name and role of the element, but its current state as well. In this example, we're using NVDA to navigate to an unchecked checkbox and then check it.
Checkbox not checked. I have read the terms and conditions. Checked.
The basic navigation for people who use a screen reader is the same as that used by keyboard users in general. The tab key is used to navigate to the next focusable element, such as links, buttons, or form inputs. To move backwards, you use Shift-Tab. Enter is used to activate links. Enter or space activate buttons. The arrow keys are used to navigate static content such as text, as well as to interact with components such as menus, tab panels, sliders, select dropdowns, and groups of radio buttons. Beyond the basics, however, people who use a screen reader have many more keyboard commands at their disposal. Where sighted people will visually scan a page, then make a decision about where to navigate to or what to concentrate on, screen reader users will do the same, but with keyboard commands. While screen readers often have different keyboard commands, people tend to use the same general strategy for exploring, navigating, and reading content. When opening a web page, screen readers will automatically read the page from top to bottom, starting with the page title. It's common for people to stop the screen reader, then explore the content for themselves. A common strategy is to scan a page using headings or landmark regions, then use other keyboard commands to explore relevant content in more detail. This enables people to understand the overall structure of content before deciding what to do next. For example, a screen reader user may navigate between the headings on the page until they find one that seems to preface the content they're looking for. Then, they'll use more keyboard commands to read the subsequent content, activate a link, or perform some other task. In this example, we're using NVDA to navigate between the headings on the tetralogical website using the H key. Once we reach a heading that interests us, we continue using the Tab key to reach the following link.
Hello, your tetralogical heading level 1. News heading level 2. Blog heading level 2. Contact us heading level 2. Main region, hello at tetralogical.com, send mail link.
Probably the most common setting people change is the rate of speech output. Many people who use screen readers on a daily basis listen to the speech output very fast. This is similar to how someone who's sighted might skim read and read fast in their head. The speech rate can be so fast that output is almost impossible to follow for people unaccustomed to screen readers. As an example, here we change the speaking rate in NVDA speech settings from 60% to 100%. And then read through content on the tetralogical website's homepage.
Rate, slider 60 alt plus R. 100. Main landmark below, we're tetralogical heading level 1. We're a company with inclusion at its heart. We specialize in all aspects of accessibility, from working with your websites and apps to giving your teams the skills they need to make accessibility part of everything they do.
These are some of the high-level details about desktop screen readers and common strategies that people browsing with a desktop screen reader use. To find out more about accessibility, visit tetralogical.com.